hearts, and the rage and the sadness that they feel kind of breaks me a little bit.
Yeah, it's an awful, awful situation. Why do you think, and I know you've done a lot of reporting on this, a lot of research on this, you're working on a new book as well. There has been, according to the ADL, this increase in anti-Semitic incidents here in the United States.
Yeah, and it's the largest, according to the ADL, the largest one-year increase since the organization has started tracking this in 1979. And that year happened to be the first year of Donald Trump's presidency. You've talked to the now president about this back in 2016. You know, this tale of kind of anti-Semitic comments, anti-Semitic tropes seem to follow him everywhere, to the point where his Jewish son-in-law had to write an op-ed saying, "My father-in-law is not an anti-Semite." Well, you know, usually if people keep it, if you have to say that, it means people keep accusing you of being an anti-Semite, and there might be fire where that, you know, anti-Semitic smoke is. And I think that he has emboldened and heartened a lot of people who hear the dog whistles. They know exactly what they mean. They feel that the president approves. They have said as much. That if you look at alt-right commentary after the president's moral equivocation on Charlottesville, if you look at his inability to, until really forced, to denounce people like David Duke, former Grand Wizard of the KKK, they understand this, and they understand that he's on their side. He's not on the side of frankly, of the Jewish community.
This killer, he posted a lot of anti-Semitic posts on social media, but he also went after Donald Trump. He said at one point, Trump is surrounded by, and then he used the derogatory word for Jews that starts with a K, things that will stay the course. Trump is a globalist, not a nationalist. There is no MAGA, make America great again, as long as there is a derogatory K word for Jews, infestation. So it doesn't look like he was a great fan of Donald Trump.
But I think this rhetoric is out there. It's in the air. All the attacks on George Soros, all the talk about globalists, that is so barely veiled. I mean, the veil is see-through. These are anti-Semitic tropes that the president is trafficking in, has been trafficking in, for at least the 3 years since he started running. And it's not a coincidence that these people pick up on this and they think, you know, if you're talking about this, let's actually do something about this. They get so riled up that even what he says is not enough.
It's a sad situation indeed. Are you upbeat or pessimistic about the immediate future?
I'm angry. Yeah, I'm angry. I think this, angry. Yeah.
Understandably so. All right, Julia Ioffe, thanks so much for coming in.
Thank you for having me.
Good luck. Give our love to your parents as
well.
Thank you. This is CNN special live coverage.